the field, the road run by, to manage our Camelot. And up and down the people go, gazing where the lilies blow. Round an island there below, the island of Shalott. A bow shot from her bower heaves, he rode between the burgundy sheaves. The sun came dazzling through the leaves and flamed upon the brazen greaves of old Sir Lancelot. Red Cross Knight forever kneeled to a lady in his shield, and sparkled on the yellow field beside remote Shalott. She left the web, she left the loom, she made three paces through the room. She saw the water lily bloom, she saw the helmet and the plume. She looked out to Camelot. Out through the web and floated wide, the mirror cracked from side to side. The curse has come upon me, cried the Lady of Shalott. In the stormy east wind straining, the pale yellow woods were waning. The broad stream in his banks complaining, heavily the long sky raining over towered Camelot. Down she came and found a boat beneath the willow left afloat, and round about the prow she wrote, the Lady of Shalott. Who is this and what is he? In the light of battle's near, stand the stand of royal cheer. They cross themselves for fear, the knights at Camelot. Lancelot mused a little space. He said, she has a lovely face. God in his mercy lent her grace, the Lady of Shalott.
Okay, so let's do the Highwayman next. Right. Here we go. Among the ghastly trees, the moon was a ghostly galleon tossed upon the cloudy seas. The road was a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moon. A highwayman came riding, riding, riding. A highwayman came riding up to the old inn door. He had a French cocked hat on his forehead, a bunch of lace at his chin, a cord of claret velvet, and breeches of brown doe skin. They fitted but never a wrinkle. His
cross were up to the thigh, and he cried with a jewel twinkle, his pistol parts a twinkle, his rapier heels a twinkle unto the jeweled sky. And over the corpse he clattered, and clashed in the darkened yard, and he tapped with his whip on the shutters, but all was locked and barred. He whistled a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, the landlord's red-lipped daughter, plaiting her long red love note into her long black hair. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart, I'm after a prize tonight, and I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning. Yet if they press me sharply and harry me through the day, then look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight, I'll come to thee by the moonlight, though hell should bar the way. He rose upright in his stirrups, his scarce could reach a hand, she'd loosened her hair in the casement, his face was like a brand. As a black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast, and he kissed its waves in the moonlight, oh, sweet waves in the moonlight, tugged at his friend in the moonlight, and galloped away to the west. Come at the dawning, he did not come at noon, and out of the tawny sunset, before the rise of the moon, when the road was a gypsy's ribbon, looping the purple moor, King George's men came marching, 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 King George's men came marching up to the olden door. They said no word to the landlord, they drank his ale instead, and they bound and gagged his daughter to the foot of a narrow bed. Two of them knelt to the casement with the muskets at the side. There was death at every window, hell at one dark window, for Bess could see through the casement the road that he would ride. They tied her attention with many a snickering jest, and they bound a musket beside her with a bar beneath the breast. Now keep good watch, and they kissed her. She heard the dead man say, look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight, I'll come to thee by the moonlight, through hell shall bar the way. She twisted her hands behind her, but all the knots held good. She writhed her hands till her fingers were wet with sweat and blood. They stretched and strained in the darkness, and the hours crawled by the queues to know when the stroke of